ourselves, big God. And Father God, we say thank you. Pray, Lord, right now that you would bless us in this place like you already have, Father God. Work through this vessel, Lord, to be able to be a blessing to everybody here, dear God. And I just pray that we leave this place better than the way we came. We love you, we praise you, and we honor your holy name. What's in the mighty, blessed, and wonderful name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. 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 You may be seated at this time. Amen. Before I do begin, I want to do a little housekeeping. All right. Amen. All right. And we are going to go straight into the word. Amen. I don't plan to keep you long at all. Amen. I would like at this time for all those who have traveled from the St. Mary Missionary Baptist Church to be with Pastor, I would like you to stand, amen, at this time. Amen. St. Mary family, would you please stand? Amen. I thank God for each and every one of them. And I have my children in the house, amen. That's that whole back row, amen. Amen. All of my children, would you stand at this time? Amen. 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 My five, and they keep me alive. Amen. Amen. I want to also ask my beautiful wife, Chantel, is here as well. Would you stand, please? Amen. Amen. I thank God for my wife. Amen. And Pastor, every time they see her, they say, who that little girl he got with him? Amen. But she's of age. Amen. She just look good. That's all. Amen. And I'm glad about it. Amen. I want to thank God for you all coming out and joining me on today. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Truly, it's good. Pastor Jenkins, a man that has such a servant's heart. And I thank God for him, and I thank God for his ministry. And I thank God for him even thinking about me to come out and to share a word with you all. Amen. Amen. All of my other co-laborers in the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. And everyone here, I send you greetings from the St. Mary Missionary Baptist Church out of the big city of Port Barry, Louisiana. Amen. Amen. If you blink, you will miss it. Amen. You will miss it. So I just thank God that some good stuff come out of little towns. Amen. Amen, amen. But there is a word on today, and I'm going to ask, amen, that you would stand for the reading of the word, if you can, amen, if you will. And we're going to go to Psalm 37, 5 through 6.
All right, all right.
Psalm 37, 5 through 6.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Psalm 37, 5 through 6.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. The Word of God says, commit your way to the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
You must trust also in Him.
Mm-hmm.
And He shall bring it to pass.
Right.
Jesus.
He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light, and your justice as the noonday.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. For subject on today, a committed heart. All amen. Right, you may be seated at this time. A committed heart.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. When we look at the Psalm 37, it is a passage where we have the psalmist writing about the experiences that they're going through.
Uh-huh.
And if you keep on going to bed and getting up in the morning, you're going to go through something.
Come on with it, Pastor.
So when we look at the passage and we look throughout the whole 37th Psalm, we will discover that the psalmist shares some things that they go through and some adversities that they face based on the different things that they have to go through as it relates to doing the will of God.
All right, all right.
Well, when we look at the scripture in line 5, it says, commit your way to the Lord. Let the church say commit. Now, when I did a study of the word commit, it shocked me. When I did a study of the word commit, it really means to roll away or roll down or to roll together.
All right.
Now, when I did the study, I'm like, okay, Lord, what in the world do you want me to know about something rolling? I know how to roll a basketball. I know how to roll a baseball. I know how to roll a bowling ball. But what in the world does rolling have to do with commitment?
All right.
I'm so glad you asked me. When you look at rolling as it relates to commitment, it is you rolling what you have in your hand to the master's hand.
All right. All right.
And that blessed my life, because how many of you know, until you truly give something up, you can't truly commit.
Yeah.
See, commitment says that I have what I have in my hand and I transfer it over to the Lord.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
See, commitment says that, guess what, Lord, whatever I have in my hand, you can take it and make it bigger and better than what I can make it out to be. So when you look at that whole idea of rolling, it really means a transfer of what you have in your possession to God himself.
All right.
This illustration came to mind. I thought about a vehicle when it has broken down.
Uh-huh.
How many of us in here can testify that it's no fun when the vehicle won't start? When you go to crank the car and you know you got gas, but that doesn't matter, something is wrong with the vehicle that you're trying to start. And really and truthfully, it's a bad thing, and a very bad thing, when you are out somewhere and the car won't crank. See, it's one thing to crank when you can't crank when you're already at the house, but it's something else when you can't crank and you're not at the house.
All right.
Well, Pastor, what that got to do with commitment and rolling? I'm so glad you asked me. This is what it means. How many of you can say that you might have ran out of gas, or the car might have been broke down, or whatever it might be, but the gas station or the mechanic shop was somewhere down the road, you couldn't fix it, you didn't know what to do, but if you rolled it where you needed it to go, then it would start and it would crank and it would do what it needed to do. Well, Pastor, what you want me to do with that? I want you to do this with that. You might have a ministry in your heart. You might have something that you're trying to do. You might have somewhere you're trying to go and something you are trying to accomplish. Can I help you? You get it out of your hands and you roll it to God. Says, commit your way
to the Lord.
See, roll it. You got to roll it on to the one who can take it and make it bigger and better than what you can make it out to be.
Yes, sir.
See, some of you have to roll your way over to church today. Some of you have to roll your way to Bible study this week.
Yeah.
Some of y'all have to roll yourself out the bed to get where you needed to get, so you can get down on your knees like Mother Harrison and tell the Lord, thank you.
Yeah.
See, when you commit to God, you can roll what you have and give it to God and say, God, I give it up. Because I can't do with it what you can do with it.
My Lord.
Look what the word says. It says, trust also in him. Let the church say trust.
Trust.
Let the church say trust.
Trust.
Let the church say trust.
Trust.
See, there's a difference between trust and belief.
Amen.
Where you going, preacher? See, belief says that I believe that it is what it is, but trust says that I'm going to trust it enough to do with it, or that it's going to do for me what I need it to do for me. Okay? When you look at the idea of trust, it's really being confident that God is who he says that he is. When I was younger, about 16 years old, and I shared this with my congregation once before, but the Lord gave me this illustration again in another light. When I was 16 years old, I had the luxury of having knee surgery.
Mm-hmm.
at 16 years old. Because I was so stubborn and foolish, didn't take care of myself, do what I was supposed to do. And really and truthfully, I couldn't walk 10 steps without my knee giving out on me, Pastor. So I had to go to the doctor, and the doctor had to do something.
Yeah.
Well, when I went to the orthopedic doctor, he couldn't do for me what really I needed to be done. So he sent me to somebody else that could do what he couldn't do. I'm going somewhere with this. See, when I went into his office, the guy that he referred me to, when I went to his office, he showed me that he had practiced sports medicine for so many years. But you see, the thing about it and the thing that sold me was this, Brother Sylvester. He put on the wall all of the different NBA players and NFL players that he had worked on. And he had given me his resume. And he had told me all the different people that the Lord had allowed him to work on. And you know what happened, Pastor Jenkins? In my heart of heart, I was confident that he knew what he was doing. See, you got to understand that God knows what he is doing. And based on his track record and what he's done for you already, how many of you in here can say that God can be trusted because he made a way out of no way? He did what you couldn't do yourself. And even when mama or daddy, your brother or sister couldn't do, he was able to do it for you. Trust. Be confident.
Yeah. All right now.
In him.
Yeah.
In him.
My Lord. My Lord.
Got to be confident.
Confident.
In God being God.
All right, all right.
It says, and he shall bring it to pass.
Yes, he will.
And he shall bring it to pass. I think y'all missed it. I'll read it again. It says, and he shall bring it. I'll say it one more time. You should have been shouted by now. And he shall bring it to pass. See, how many of you know that when you sincerely, truly give something to God to work with, that he gonna take it? And whatever it is that's in your heart for it to do, and whatever God wills it to do, it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. See, how many of you know as Christians sometimes we limit God? Because we don't expect nothing from God sometimes. We'll walk around like God can't do for us what he can do for us. We'll walk around like he can't make a way out of nowhere. We'll walk around like God is not the master of the universe. But I'm here to tell you, if he woke you up this morning, started you on your way, he created the heavens of the earth, and he did all that he did for you and I, guess what? He's already proven that he is who he is. He shall bring it to pass.
Oh, yeah.
Tell your neighbor he's able. He shall bring it. He shall bring it to pass. What do you want me to know, Pastor? You can expect God to prosper whatever you devote to him.
Amen.
You can expect God to prosper whatever it is you devote to him.
My Lord.
Well, when you look at being devoted to God and giving what you give to him and him allowing it to come to pass, it reminds me of, if anybody ever worked in management, amen, or you may be on the other end, many times there's individuals that get called on all of the time to do certain things.
Amen.
I'm going to help somebody in here today.
Uh-huh.
Don't look at some people and look at them side-eyed and otherwise because pastor or certain individuals are always called on. Don't get mad. I'm just here to tell you that really and truthfully, pastor knows that if I call on them, they going to get some stuff done.
Yeah. All right.
But pastor, what that got to do with what you say? You see, you've got to understand, just like that faithful employee, you've got to understand that guess what? I don't care what you give to God, that guess what? He can do what he says he can do.
Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah.
And he's able to bring it to pass.
Yes.
Able to bring it to pass. How many of you are trying to do something that God really you feel God has laid upon your heart to do. How many of you have a book in your spirit you know that God, that the Lord wants you to write? How many of you have a ministry that you know that God wants you to actually pursue? Can I help you? Until you roll that thing to God, he ain't going to bring it to pass.
My Lord.
You know why? Because you know what ends up happening? Sometimes we try to work our own abilities when God is saying, you don't have to be as good as you think you need to be. You just need to trust that I can take what you got and make it be what it needs to be.
Yeah.
So you've got to understand that God shall bring it to pass. Says this in line 6. It says, and he shall bring forth your righteousness as the light, and your justice as the noonday. He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light, and your justice as the noonday. When it says bringing forth your righteousness, that means that the good that you do, the things you do in his name, the things you do in the will of God, he's going to take it and he's going to allow you to be recognized for your righteousness. He's going to reveal the fact that your heart is where it really is. But I gotta throw this in there. You don't have to go out with your card and with your flyer and try to convince folk that you can do what you can do.
All right.
You want the Lord to create your business card as opposed to you creating your own business card. Because see, the business card that God creates, can I help you? No man can erase it. No man can change the ink. No man can do anything. Because you know what? What you do in the secret places of your heart, God will bring it in the open. Well, preacher, where you get this from? Well, when I looked in the book of Matthew and I studied the Sermon on the Mount, there's three areas that God told us that you just be quiet about.
Come on.
And if you just be quiet about it, I'm going to allow some stuff to come to pass. He said, that's what you've done in secret. I'll allow it to show up in the open.
All right.
Well, what three areas, Pastor? In your giving, in your praying, and in your fasting.
Amen. All right.
The things you do in the will of God, to serve God, to connect with God, God says what you do in the secret, I will reward you openly.
Yeah.
Where you going with this, Pastor? Well, in that same passage of scripture, it talks about individuals who boast about all the stuff that they give and all the things that they do, that boast about trying to say that they're fasting, and they boast about all the praying that they do, and they'll stand in the synagogues and make these long prayers. But can I help you? God say, guess what? That's some time you've got to go in your secret room, and the very thing you do in your secret room, I'll bring it to light, and folk will know that you are walking with me.
All right.
See, God won't allow your good works to go unnoticed. You know what blessed me in that passage of scripture? He says, those who boast and brag about what they do for the Lord, he says they have their reward. What's the reward? You get the praise of men. I want to encourage somebody in here today.
Come on, son. My God.
You don't need the praise of men to know you're doing the will of God. See, you got to understand, sometimes God will put you in a situation to where it seems like nobody appreciates what you're doing. It kind of reminded me of Pastor Jeremiah, Pastor. When I looked at the story of Jeremiah and how he preached to folk to try to get them right and to try to lead them in the right direction, to try to get them to live right and to do right and to honor God, he had folk that laughed at him, they spit on him, they talked about him, and they said, yeah, that old fine brimstone preacher. And Jeremiah had nerve enough to tell God, God, you deceived me. And when he tried to stop preaching, he said it was just like fire shut up in my bones. Anybody in here have ever been to the point to where you felt like giving up? You wanted to stop, you wanted to quit, nobody appreciated you, but the Lord said, go on just a little while longer. You will reap if you faint not. God won't allow your good works to go unnoticed. He will bring it. He will bring it to pass. He's going to bring it to light. And it says he's going to bring forth your righteousness as the light. And really that light is kind of like the dawn. You ever been sitting on the porch when the sun is about to come up in the morning? Now the sun don't come up, amen. We just move around and the sun do what it need to do, amen. But to us, the sun coming up or rising in the morning. But when the sun, at sunrise, it's amazing how when it's just as dark as it wants to be, and it seems as though that light creeps up on me. Can I help somebody here today? That there's some stuff that God's gonna do that just might creep up on you. And when you would have quit and stopped, God will show you, yeah, I know you've been weary. I know you've been faint. I know you've been going through. But guess what? Here it is. And guess what? He'll do it slow to let you know, yeah, it's on display. Because guess what? Your faithfulness is rewarded. And he says, and your justice as the noonday. All I'm trying to get us to see here today is that we need to live right and do right and commit our heart to God. And when we're obedient to God and we're obedient to his will, can I help you? God will bless that what it is that you are doing. And I'm reminded of the fact that when you look at Christ and all the things that he's done on our behalf, that really and truthfully, Christ went through some things that really and truthfully, many of us may not be willing to go through. You see, what I discovered was this, is that Christ claimed to be the Son of God, and he was, and he still is. And God and Christ claimed to be the Savior of the world, and he still is. And what ended up happening, the very people he came to save is the very people that really and truthfully ridiculed him. Now, you know what's amazing about that? Is that Christ could have said, I ain't worrying about you, Brother Walker, because I ain't dealing with them folk talking about me. I'm not dealing with them folk plucking my beard. I'm not dealing with those folk putting a crown of thorns on my head. I'm not dealing with those folk ridiculing me and talking about me, because guess what? I don't know Brother Walker deserved this. I didn't deserve this, but you know what Jesus said? I don't care if men appreciate me. I know my purpose. He said, I'm going to die for a sin-sick world, and he had nerve enough to say to the very ones who was taking his life, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. I'm here to help somebody. There may be somebody lying on you, talking about you, mistreating you, misusing you. Remember now, they know not what they do, because many a time what people do, many people will fight your anointing. Many people will fight what it is that God put you here to do. Many people will fight because they don't really understand that what you're here to do is really here to bless them. But you can't stop, because the very people that do the things that they do to you may be the very people that you end up blessing in the long run. Don't you get mad, don't you get weary, and don't you get upset. They tell me that they hung my Savior high, and they stretched him wide, and they hung his head, but for me and you, he died, and they put him in a borrowed tomb. They tell me early the third day morning, he got up with all power in his hand. How many of you can testify that God has done some great and amazing things for you? How many of you know that it's the blood of Jesus that has washed your white as snow? How many of you know it's the blood of Jesus that's going to continue to keep you day after day and night after night? Give what you got to Jesus. Give what you got to the Lord. Because I'm here to tell you that greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Give God some praise in here today, because he alone is worthy. He's worthy of your praise. He's worthy of your time. He's worthy of your energy. He's worthy of your devotion. He's worthy of your love. He's worthy of your time. He's worthy of everything you can give him. And whatever you do for Christ, it will last. He's worthy, I tell you. He's worthy, I tell you. Have a committed heart. Have a heart that understands that whatever you have in your hand ain't good enough if you don't rule it to the Lord and let him bless it. It might be your family. Roll it. Roll it to God. Relinquish the belief that you can fix it yourself. Relinquish the belief that you don't need no help. And understand that all God wants you to do is take your ministry, your family, your situations, your adversaries, your day-to-day. He wants you to take it, roll it to him.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
My.
True commitment. A committed heart understands that it's about giving up something.
Oh,
yeah. Wait, Pastor, giving? True commitment is about giving up and giving it to the one who can bless it beyond your wildest dreams.
Yes.
Give God some praise in here. I'm done. Yeah. Amen. He is worthy. He is worthy.
Yeah.
He is worthy. Yeah. He be praised. Yeah. Amen. Yeah.